Now, why do I like the rotary? Well, the rotary, I think, gives a cleaner cut, and a crisp cut. And then you could follow it up with a dual action, you know, to help give it a little bit more clarity. But this gives you that cut, and that's what I want. Notice my pad, it's not all caked up. You know, some people like a caked up pad, I don't. I like to know what my wool is doing and how my wool is cutting. If I'm using the whole pad surface, then I don't know if I'm cutting here, am I cutting here, am I cutting here, am I cutting here, am I cutting in the center? Well, let's say this whole area needs to be cut. So if I put the whole pad on flat, yeah, you'll cut it all, but now what if you really need to cut only over here? You put the whole pad on flat to go here and then cut everything else around it again? No, and just go to that area, hit that spot, work it, move along, move along, move along. This little area right here. Change the angle a little bit. So now, this has been cleared over. This is a rusty spot and there's a dent. But notice the panel's all flimsy like this. So you cannot put a lot of pressure. And you'll see people who are using dual actions really pressing to try to get the correction going and the cut. You don't need to do that. Okay, all you're doing is putting too much pressure on a panel, basically. So here, you notice that there's an edge, there's an edge, there's an edge. This thing's going this way. So, you gotta be careful. You can say, well, you could use a smaller pad, yeah. Or I could just change up my body English. So, going this way, I could get to the edge. Going this way, I'm going this way. I'm cutting on this side, going to the edge, and when I get to here, it gets dangerous because I'm going towards that point. So how do I fix that? Body English is going to have to be like this, and I'm not going to be hitting this part. I'm going to be hitting this part and going up this way. And I'm looking and I'm looking. Okay? So it's a matter of finding the direction you need to go when you have an area such as this. Or you can change to a smaller pad. Sense of difficulty and how you can be careful, here's how you do it. So, first of all, I want to get this area, so I'm just going to grab a little bit of the polish. Get this area taken care of. And even though I'm going that way, I'm tilted away. I'm going away. Watch all the different angles I'm going at this. Starts to get a little too bouncy. I'll increase the speed a little bit. Yeah, I know where I'm carrying the polish. I'm bringing it to where I need it. I'm only getting enough that I just need a little bit. Not even touching that corner. Now I'm going to go up there. So I bring some polish up there. Right up there. If I need more, that's why I use the brush. Put a little bit right there. Oh, that's a little too much. A little too much. But watch. I just have to make that work over here. A little bit in that little section. Yeah, I'm just hitting that little area. Very precise. I'm not putting a lot of pressure. But it's polishing it. Alright. You see that, right? I'm gonna change it here. Better angle. Now there's some polish right there, so I'll work with that. And now I'll change my angles a little bit, so I'm going off to this side. Yeah, that's all good. But I'm not putting a lot of pressure on there. Alright. Letting the pad in the polish. Letting it all work for me. You see this little bit right there? I don't know if you can take like that, but I'll show you. A little bit right there. And I'll use some that little bit right here. And I'm just gonna get to that edge. See? I still left it. It's still there, because I didn't go so far over. So look. It's still there. That's how I know what my edge is, because I'm using this pad. And I know how to control by looking, seeing, and using the speed and the polish to do the work. Now if I were to bend more, I'd bend it. This would get bent. It's already bent enough on the accident. So here, I'll wipe it clean. And then I'll just focus on the rest of it. Alright, I'm gonna pull the camera back. Get a better view. Because this stuff here is next. Right here. So that little bit. Right there. I want the clean, crisp cut. Now, I'm just going to take a little bit and work them over. See? Just a little bit. All I need to work that corner. Here's a better angle for you to see. This way. Alright? Zoom it in. I'm going to grab a little bit of that. And I'm going away. So if I'm going to be here, I'm going away this way. If I'm going to be here, then I got to be even more careful that I'm going away that way. Here, watch. I got to look, and you got to look. If I get my head in there, it's because I'm trying to really see. This corner. And I'm going to pinpoint where I'm hitting, so I know exactly where that little spot right there. You see that little spot? You're just moving a little bit of it. utilizes my polish. Use a little bit more. Now we're right at the very corner. Go, there. Wipe it, as you can see. Nice and shiny. All right, so that's a delicate spot, right? Delicate spot. So now I'm gonna approach it from this angle. Next thing is working this right here. Working this lower area. So let me just do a wipe. This area still needs it. Okay, but the way that I see the light the best, I'm gonna go from this direction so I can see as I'm making my way over. Let's put some right here. I'd like to know what my wool is doing. I'm going to crank it up a little bit more. Grab a little bit right there. I'm going to put some of this over here. Here, put it right there. Now I am cutting, that's why I like the V handle. So I can rotate, go on an edge easy. Set. And if I'm working my way this way, watch. Watch it as you look. You see how this angle is open? So I'm cutting from the front now. I'm maintaining the angle through the cut. Bottom side. Grabbing what I need and working with it. Now this polisher is noisy. It is loud, so you should wear ear protection. So we'll go along and put some hearing protection right now. And also, it's a good idea to, ear protection is great, and also eye protection, of course, but also for your lungs. The material they have in here, which does all the leveling and cutting, is gonna be, there's a residue and becomes powdery. And you can breathe it in. You don't breathe a lot of it in. The old stuff used to contain silica, but they all contain a form of aluminum oxide or some sort of item like that. So you don't want to be breathing aluminum oxide. Not good. So,
I'm just going to go
a little bit faster and get moving here. This is a pretty big pad for the small space that I'm working on. Small fender. But I can make it work. Keep on going here. You know, and sweep it. Sweep the dust down, sweep the dust down, sweep the dust down, and
all right, well, I need to see it. I put some right there. I'm gonna start slow again because I gotta get in that one.
And I'm looking at the light to see how it's cutting.
Okay, I can see it from this angle. No, don't pay any attention to all the defects that are in it. This is a jump panel, remember? You can see that dent. But look at the surface. It's clear.
can still see a little right there.
What I'm seeing.
See right there? Now I know where those are. I will, first of all, spot them. Put, there we go. Right there. And right there. Anything else? I'm looking right now. Nope. Get those spots. I always look down.
I may have been up here. So I always look down. Get it back down.
If I'm going to go delicate. The pad's covering what my view is, so I gotta go to this side and see here. And now I gotta see here, so I gotta go this side. Still, tiny little bit. If you don't get all those spots now, it's gonna be a lot more difficult later in the final finishing phase. Dust. That's why you should wear a mask, because you know you're breathing all that stuff in. But for right now, as I'm trying to talk, it's easier to converse. But we'll figure out a way so you can hear me. Now when you get a little bit of stuff sort of cakes over like that, should add a little bit right there. You can move with your finger, you're good. If you can't, then it's gonna need to get softened with a little spritz or a little more, just to help soften it up so it's not hard crusty. There's a sweet spot to the sound. The sweet spot to the way it cuts at a certain sound. Like right now, it's cutting, I can feel it cut. There, if I pressure down, I'm really cutting. Makes it go smooth, it's faster. But you gotta be careful, because now you're dealing with more speed. You can have a light touch on it. You don't want to go too heavy and hard, otherwise this thing is going to start cutting too much. And
you can actually start to get too much heat if you're not careful, so.
It's not that hot. It's fairly cool. So here, you can see it, nice effortless glide. When you have a panel that you need, that can bend, support it for the backside, just to give it an added protection that you're not going to damage it. soften it up. Sometimes you might get that little bit of a... Now notice that I'm not even wearing my apron, but I don't have a lot of sling all over me. You know, it's not spraying all over the place. That's because I'm careful to keep it confined to where I need it. I don't do this. I don't do this. And then all over the place. I just put it where I need it. Focus on that, move along. Focus on that, move along. And pretty soon, then I can do long sweeps. But right now, I'm focused on getting that area corrected with a good cut. All right, so now you can go with a foam pad to give it a little bit more shine. Or I can stay with a wool pad and a different polishing compound and watch the difference. Okay, so you can see that it's got good reflection. There's a light bulb, and there's a light bulb. So it's got clarity in the cut. Let's see, there you go, there. It's got clarity in the cut. All the way through. Clarity in the cut. So now we want more out of that panel. Go for the absolute best paint on a paint level. Get the paint absolute perfect. So we're gonna add another element here. We're gonna add some actual polishing compound. Now use different polish. Now this I can go faster. With this stuff, I can go faster because I'm no longer cutting. Now I'm just floating along and giving it some shine. So know what the purpose of what you're trying to do to your paint. That's the biggest thing. Are you trying to cut the clear? Or are you trying to luster the clear? So now we're not even lustering it a lot right now. Okay, this isn't even really lustering. This is just getting it smooth and getting at the scratches. Now we're gonna do a little bit more to make it shinier. So, once again, I'll start up here. And there, don't need a lot. And this is the last slippery air. I'm going to change my English. Now we're going to see. Okay. See from every angle. Okay. I like the way it's sort of bouncifying, so I'm going to go over the left. That's weird though. Still a little bouncified. getting a little bit more luster to it. Just a little bit more. And I'm gonna spur this pad real quick just to give it a little bit more
freshness.
I'm not really trying to cut now, remember? Cutting's over. Now I'm trying to give it a standing faster. Go for that shine. I'm going to give the knife to the carry. Also got my eyes looking at this. No longer cutting, I'm only getting to electrify. Get it electrified. A little bit there. Oh, it's electrified. Getting flatter, but this is a pretty big pad for such a small panel.
Pretty big pad for a small panel. All
right. Yeah. So, let me do a wipe on it. I had to take the earplugs just so I can hear myself talk. Good. So, I don't know,
Okay. There. That looks nice over there.
That's how you want to look at a panel. You want to look at it from all sides, all angles, to get the reflection of the light. You know, all sides, all angles, get the reflection of the light. Okay, so you can see. Alright, so that's that with the Milwaukee polisher.
So, do another step. Let's look at it first. Alright, I want you to look at it close up, multiple lights. You can see the clarity.
Alright, here. Clear and sharp.
Like that. All right. So that's just with the wool pad and the rotary. Good smooth.
So there's actually still another level to this, so we can still go. And that is with dual action and a polishing pad, like a foam polishing pad. So yeah, do that. So that'll be next. All right.
Okay, I'm just gonna take the Rupus and polish it up some more.
Alright. It's taking shape. Section left in front. Okay.
There. So, how hard was that? Pretty easy when the panel is already polished. Makes polishing it again a lot easier.
So, that's the video for this panel here. And it's nice and smooth, don't want to touch it. Alright, well, thank you for watching the video.